In this video, we are going to get a terminal emulator. And the terminal emulator that we're going to use is from GitHub. So alternatively, you could just download any old terminal emulator. There's other ones out there, but we're going to use GitHub's terminal emulator because we'll also need GitHub. And so we're going to download that from GitHub for Windows. And then if by the way, you work on a Mac or on Linux or something like that, then you don't need to watch this video because you already are able to run the terminal. But if you're working on Windows, you need to watch this video. So we're going to download a terminal emulator from GitHub. And then in settings, we're going to choose the terminal we want. We're going to choose the shell or something like that. We'll see what it's called in a second. Then we're going to open it and test it. We're going to take a look at a few basic terminal commands. Apparently, I'm having trouble articulating. So one thing you could do is just go to Google. We're not going to do this, but you could look for other terminal emulators. And so I just searched here for terminal emulator Windows. It's a bit of a tongue twister. Instead, we're going to go to a website called github.com. So if you're new to programming and you stick with it, GitHub will become very familiar to you. And I'm actually logged in right now. So what I want to search for is let me launch a different browser. And I gotta choose my poison here. Anything but Chrome is poison. And I'm gonna go to github.com again. And there we go. And so learn more about GitHub, pricing, sign up. I'm sure there's some download somewhere. Collaboration from your desktop, find out more. Download GitHub Windows 7 or later. So that's what I want. I'm gonna download that. And save this to my desktop and run it. So this is now launched after I've run it, and this is exactly what I want to use. So I could go in here and go to settings, and I could choose options. And inside options, I could choose Git Bash. So that's the one I want. I don't want PowerShell, I want Git Bash. So I'm going to go back here to my notes and change my notes to not PowerShell, but Git Bash. There we go. And I'm going to save that. And now I will close GitHub, that piece of software. I no longer need that. But I could go to Start and I could go to All Programs and I could look under GitHub and open up that folder. And I have the Git shell right here. Alternatively, if you're working like in a newer Windows version, you could just type in into the search box Git shell or however you find programs and launch them. So I'm going to launch the Git shell. And so I should be able to run Unix-based commands now. And you can learn about some of the different commands that you could use at the command line by typing in Unix terminal commands, right? And so basic Unix commands. You could also just type in terminal commands. So there's different ones. I had a really good website up earlier. How to use basic Unix commands. Here we go. This is a nice one. And here are some of the commands. ls will list all of our directories. cd will allow us to change directories. pwd is print working directories. So let's see some of that in action. So right here I'm in documents. I want to list everything in my documents. I could do an ls, and that lists it all. That's a list. I don't know what it stands for. It kind of sounds like list to me, so that's what I think it stands for. That's ls. I could do ls-la, which in my mind I say list all, which gives me some of that data. I could also do a print working directory to see which directory I'm in. So it just printed my working directory there. So I could also use cd to change into some directory. So let's say I wanted to go into the folder where I'm keeping all the videos for this course I'm recording. I could type in ude, right? Just start the file, the folder name I want, and then press tab, and it'll give me some of the options and complete it partially. And then I could just type g and O, and that's it. I gotta complete it because I have two that are pretty similarly named. And then I can hit enter. So now I can see what's inside that folder. And I could, CD into old. And like here are like some, videos that I created, which, I was like, I'm gonna do a different approach. All right, and then I could do a CD up dot dot slash, and that takes me up a level. And so this is how you navigate through like folder structure, right? ls, ls-la, just give me a little bit more information. And then change directory, like node, right? and an ls, what's in there, and then change directory, go up. So change directory, give it the folder you want to go into, or change directory, go up. And you know, lsla and print working directory. So those are some really basic Unix commands, and we're going to see how to do a few more commands as we start doing some Go programming. We'll use the terminal to run some stuff. So you need to have the terminal, and we'll be using Unix commands, and now you have it, we're going to start doing stuff. And the cool thing about the terminal, if you're new to programming, it really makes you feel like you're doing something programming style, like you know, oh, I'm really starting to get into computers, I'm working at the terminal. It's kind of cool. All right, so in the next video, in this video we just sort of like saw, you know, how we could get a terminal from GitHub, and we saw a few basic commands like ls, lsla, cd, cd, dot, dot, slash to go up and print working directory. In the next one, I'm going to show you how to do a SHA-1 checksum to verify we have a good, you know, code base to install, and we downloaded what was intended. That's a better way to say it. And so we're going to see that in the next video. That's pretty cool. And we'll do that at the terminal. That's going to be fun.